Beautiful Leos, and welcome to your June reading. This is going to be Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. All right, you guys. So for the month of June, I am doing a special. So for those of you guys interested in purchasing a personal reading in my website, there are readings that are $10 off, up to $20 off, depending on which reading you decide to purchase. So go ahead and take advantage of that if you feel called to book a reading. Those of you guys that are new, welcome. If you guys are returning, I'm so glad to have you back. Feel free to subscribe if you haven't already, as that is always greatly appreciated. Those of you guys that are new, all of the subscribers that I have on here are automatically entered in a giveaway every single month to win a free tarot reading. If you guys want more content, feel free to follow me on Instagram. I do giveaways there for tarot readings, questions, as well as free extended readings. We also have more content there. I've been feeling called to do more daily messages, so I am doing probably between 4 and 5 days. There's a 1 minute message for all of you guys there, as well as on the weekends we do all signs energy, so I go through each and every one of the signs. Other than that, let's just get started. All right, so let's see. Show me what Leo needs to see for the month of June, please. Messages for Leo. Whoa. Ten of Pentacles right away. Wow. And the Queen of Pentacles. So money is on the mind. Look what we have at the bottom of the deck. Strength. This is you guys. So yeah, you guys are coming in strong. I'm getting goals being realigned here. Some of you guys are really, you know, making some serious plans for your long-term goals. This could have to do with retirement. Some of you guys, this has to do with making some sort of big purchase. This could be purchasing your dream home. Making some decisions within your career to be able to make some large purchases. But I definitely sense that you guys are feeling quite stable throughout this month. Some of you guys might have had a little bit of a rocky time that you were dealing with, and now you're kind of coming back into this energy where you're feeling yourself, or throughout this month you are going to be coming into this energy where you are feeling more yourself. I definitely sense that if you are in a long-term relationship, some of you guys, this is this energy where this relationship is about to be made
it's official. It's about
with this Queen of Pentacles. I'm seeing this as a proposal. I'm seeing this as the person that you're dealing with. They're looking at you and they're seeing that happy life that they want. They're seeing you as somebody that they can marry. They're seeing you as somebody that they want to have their children. Some of you, this is somebody that they want to have children with you here, but they see that strong foundation with you here. Some of you guys, I definitely sense that this is somebody that you might have had a little bit of a falling out with recently, but I feel like that falling out only made you guys realize how much you respect one another and how much you adore the connection, how much the connection means to each of you, especially if you were separated from this person and it wasn't just a small fight. Then there has definitely been a lot of reflecting on each of you guys' side, and I definitely sense an apology. If there's an apology that needs to be said, I definitely sense somebody reaching out for an apology or with an apology here. Yeah, the Eight of Wands, there's definitely going to be communication after somebody had walked away. Yeah, things are going to be balanced. Things are going to be restored between you and this person here. Some of you guys are dealing with a Sagittarius. You could be dealing with another Leo. I have all of the energies here, so it could be any sign, really. I'm just saying what I see. But things are going to be balanced out. Things are going to be aligned between you and this person. With the Eight of Cups, I definitely sense that there's this energy where there was this need to reflect. There was this need to separate. So those of you guys that separated know that was kind of the plan all along. You guys just weren't aware of, you know, what the universe had in store for you guys. And it was really about, you know, reflecting and seeing things from a different way. This could even be where somebody kind of gets a little bit too comfortable in a situation. And because of that, you know, they decided to walk away. For some weird reason, this is kind of in a weird way, in a very slight way, reminding me of the Taurus Love Extended that I just did. So if you are in any way dealing with a Taurus, definitely feel free to check out their Love Extended. I do a you versus them at one point in that reading, so feel free to check that out for sure. But with the Eight of Wands, there's definitely somebody who walked away from you, coming back in to communicate with you, wanting to reconcile with you, wanting to balance things out, wanting to apologize, and wanting to, you know, get things going with you again. I definitely feel like this is the energy of somebody where it doesn't matter how long you've been separated from them, the second that they come back into your life, it just picks back up, you know, it picks back up where you guys were as if nothing ever happened. And it's kind of, I'm almost getting, it's always been like that. So for some of you, this is somebody that you've had in your life for a very long time, and you might've had a lot of arguments with each other throughout the time that you've known one another. All right. Show me what else Leo needs to see for the month of June. Yeah, justice and the Six of Pentacles. Things are definitely being restored. Justice with the Six of Pentacles. Things are definitely being restored. Some of you guys with this Princess of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Oh, wow. Yeah, Six of Wands. Some of you guys, yeah. This person has noticed that since, if this is somebody that you're not with anymore, like, they've definitely noticed that you've grown up since the breakup. This person has really noticed that you, wow, I'm getting another message that some of you, this person thought you were the problem, and now they're realizing, since it's almost like you've elevated, and they, their life has kind of gone quite, it's almost like their life has just kind of, I don't know what the word is that I'm trying to look for right now, but it's not coming towards me. Their life is just, I'm almost getting like the word dissolving. Like, their life is just not as good as it was when you were in their life. And this person might have thought you were holding them back in certain ways, but this person is now realizing that the only thing that was holding them back is themselves. I'm definitely getting, like, as I go into this, I just looked over here and I have a pile of decks and I saw the Emperor. So I'm getting like this energy of like controlling. This person could have been trying to control you, or felt controlled by you in a sense. Just one sec. But yeah, this person is definitely seeing your glow up. They're noticing, they're spying on you 100%. And they love it though. That's the thing. It's not like, oh, they're doing better without me. Like, that's why I was like laughing so hard in the couple seconds ago. It's like, not that they're like, oh, they're doing better without me. It's like, damn, like, look at you. Like, this is somebody who actually has a lot of love for you. And if you're not going to be happy with them, they still want you to be happy. They still want to see you happy. They want to see you shine. But they would prefer it to be with them. So this person is definitely reaching out. They've definitely noticed. I'm also getting, though, that you guys have done some things. Like, with the Six of Wands, I'm getting that you guys are really putting yourselves out there. Like, you want this person to know. And the funny thing is I think you block this person on purpose, knowing that no matter you, like, you block this person, but you know that they're still watching. Like, you know that they found out a way to watch every, I'm getting stories, so I don't know if this is Instagram, whatever stories this is, but I'm getting that you've been posting your best pictures, making sure that you look the best with the intention of getting this person back. Like, you're doing this on purpose. It's like you're putting on a show for this person. It's like, this is your, oh my gosh, you guys are so cute. This is so funny. This is, it's a lot of unnecessary games that I'm getting though. But I'm almost getting like, in a weird way, I'm hearing that's what you guys need. So some of you, maybe you're married to this person, or you've been with this person for a very long time, and it kind of just died down. And it's almost like you guys playing this game is bringing that spunk back into your relationship. It's bringing back this energy of things being new, things being fresh, things being exciting again for you guys. So that is what I am seeing. These are definitely two people that really enjoy role play is what I'm getting as well. You guys bring out that wild side. That if you weren't, you know, close to a certain extent with somebody, this person, like, that person would never really, you know, that side that we all have that only a rare select few get to see, and it takes them a long time to be able to see that side. This happened instantly between you and this person. That could have been the energy that drew you guys towards one another here. But with Justice and the Six of Pentacles, there's this, and Temperance, right? It's all about balancing things out again. It's all about things coming together, things aligning here. You know, whenever you're in your head, definitely just go towards meditating to get answers. I'm definitely getting meditating will bring you the answers that you need throughout this month here. I'm definitely getting an energy of self-reflection, meditating, working with crystals, really just, you know, communicating with your higher self. Absolutely. I'm also getting mantras, right? Like, I'm getting power, you guys. Like, I'm getting, you guys have so much power with the strength energy. I'm also getting the energy of like Mars energy here, and being able to just go for your dreams, go for your goals. You know, this is the time, I'm getting, this is a good month for you guys to take a risk towards something. This is the time for you guys to really go toward your dreams, and whether that's actually taking the action that you need or taking those steps. But there's this energy where you guys are going to get this fuel of motivation within you. Like, I'm getting like, this is like this billionaire, millionaire energy, like within me that I feel now, like somebody that can, you know, turn nothing into everything. Turn nothing into everything. Some of you guys are meant to make a lot of money in your lifetime, and you're only now accepting that, or you're only now realizing that. Some of you guys, this is about throughout this month, doing that meditation and self-work, self-reflection, in order to realize how, because you all, some of you already knew you were star worthy, or you were worthy of, you know, accomplishing an empire, building an empire, but you never knew what was going to take you to that. And some of you guys, this is really the month where those messages, all the things that you're unsure about, all the things that you've been wondering about, they're going to start to make sense, and the messages are all going to start coming towards you. I really love this reading for you guys. I really love this reading. Don't look for answers on the outside. Look for them on the inside. And if you can't find them on your own, this would be a good time for you guys. Like, this month would be, of all the months, this would be a really good month for you guys to get a reading, to be able to get those messages. And I feel like throughout, it's not just getting the reading though, like after you would get a reading, there would be some messages that would come to you through this reading that would like trigger things within you. And I'm seeing that you, so some of you, what I'm seeing here is like you're getting a reading and then messages are coming towards you from this reading, and that triggers answers, but it also triggers you to do some, to be able to do this meditation and get the answers that you need for yourself. So I'm not sure how that works, but that's just what I'm seeing here. With justice, anybody who had wronged you, they're definitely getting their karma. You are getting the strength. Some of you guys, this is getting the strength out of getting your strength back, or having that glow up after somebody had really cheated on you or really hurt you, lied to you, betrayed you. You're going to be going through your glow up. This person is definitely going to be dealing with their karma. Wow. Very, very intense energies. Okay, let's see. Some of you guys could be dealing with a Libra. All right, show me what else Leo needs to see, please. Any other messages for Leo? Ten of Cups, Eight of Swords. So some of you guys are, yeah, the Hanged Woman at the end of the, or at the bottom of the deck, sorry, and the Hierophant. Some of you guys, ooh, maybe worried about marriage, right? When are you going to get married? When am I going to get married? When am I going to get to settle down, is what I'm getting. I'm getting you need to have patience and know that everything is coming towards you, but it's coming towards you in divine timing. But I do see that there is this energy of being stressed out about a family situation, being stressed out about when it is that you're going to have children, when it is that you're going to get married. But I'm also getting that it's going to come to you once you release the need to control the outcome of when. What's for you will always be for you, right? Some of you guys are also holding yourself back from a true love that is coming into your life because of the fact, like some of you guys might be running away from this person, but I'm getting somebody here is holding themselves back from accepting the fact that they're in love with somebody, accepting the fact that this is the person that they're meant to be with, accepting the fact that somebody is their soulmate. And if that's the case, then throughout this month, that person, whoever that is, if that's you or if that's the person you're dealing with, they are going to get clarity and they're going to start building and taking this a lot more serious than they were before. Any conflict is going to be resolved. This is really going to be a really good month. Any conflict that happened is going to be resolved. Karmic balance is going to be restored. It's going to be in your favor. It's almost like you have luck on your side throughout this month. Yeah, you have luck following you. Every decision that you make here, you really just have to follow your heart and follow your intuition and know that that is going to lead you to your best outcome. Don't overthink things. That's your advice, is to just not overthink. Because you don't need to think. Your intuition, the second we do anything, our intuition tells us something. Always, you know, our intuition or our gut, we can feel it, we can sense it right away. It's just that we don't believe it, and we, you know, are like, oh, what about this? What about that? What about this? And then we go on for hours and hours and hours just to find out at the end of the day that that first answer, you know what I mean? We already knew it. We already knew it, and we would have saved so much time if we just listened to ourselves, because we're never wrong. All right, so let's see. One more message, please, for Leo. The Two of Cups. So with the Six of Swords at the bottom of the deck, some of you guys are definitely moving towards your Two of Cups. Some of you are definitely moving towards your Two of Cups. Some of you guys may meet this person through travel, or you may meet that this person could be foreign, but I am definitely getting that you either have a Two of Cups in your life and this person is coming in to bring justice so that you guys can finally be together. They're coming in to bring balance. If so, this is somebody who has learned their lesson. They will not repeat the past. Others of you, this is you coming into the realization that the person that you've been hiding from and running away from isn't because you're afraid that they're going to hurt you. It's because you're afraid of allowing yourself to love. Some of you don't feel that you're worthy of the love that this person gives you. And others of you, this is all about having a new love come into your life. But this being the last message, it's going to be very strong. I feel like there's an energy of, if you're wondering why you're still single, you still have a couple of months of self-work that you need to do. But I see a new love, a very, very important love that is going to last quite a long time. Coming into your life before the end of this year here. So definitely strong soulmate energy surrounding you here. Some of you guys are definitely separated from somebody and you're communicating like telepathically with this person. I'm getting the universe knows you're going to be with this person. Your souls know you're going to be with one another. And one of you guys knows that you're meant to be together, but the other one of you is still in denial. All right, let me pull you guys one of these lover's oracles. Okay, love messages for Leo. Soulmate, and I also saw balance again, which is like the thousandth time that we've had that energy come up. So soulmate and grief. I understand that losing something is the opportunity to appreciate it. So yeah, some of you guys, like I said, you were separated from this person in order to come back with a lot of realizations that are going to help you guys to, you know, complete a process. Imagination. I embrace and nourish the creative aspect of my mind, but I'm also getting some of you guys need to be careful not to be daydreaming about, like, you're fantasizing about something, and instead of fantasizing that it's going to happen, you need to just take the action to actually make it happen. Because if you're fantasizing about something, I'm getting that the person that you're fantasizing about this thing with is also doing the same thing. You're both calling each other in, but nobody has made a move yet. And then we have soulmate. Your soulmate is already with you in spirit. Believe this and they will manifest physically, which is absolutely true with the Two of Cups here. Your soulmate is already with you either in the physical world or within spirit. But some of you, I definitely sense that there is a separation if you've already met this person. Others of you just need to believe that you are worthy of this love so that this love can come in, because I do sense this energy where you guys have been attracting similar people. And I'm also getting that the reason why your soulmate can't come in, like, you might have been doing inner work, but there's this energy of you not accepting the kind of love that you're truly meant to have. So some of you may need to forgive yourself from something that you might have done in a past relationship. But there's this energy of needing to release something before you can have this love come in, but it's literally just waiting for you. All right. Okay, and I'm seeing this, so I'm going to pull up failure. I understand that a mistake is only an opportunity to learn. And I feel like this has a lot to do with, like, maybe somebody made a mistake in a past relationship and they're afraid that they're going to repeat it. There's this energy of being afraid to repeat something else. Or maybe you hurt somebody and now you feel like you don't deserve love because you never forgave yourself for what you did. You just pushed it back, but you never accepted it for some of you. But that is what I have for you guys. If you want more clarity, feel free to book a personal reading. They're on sale right now, so definitely take advantage of that. If you enjoyed this reading, please give me a like, share, and subscribe. That is always greatly appreciated. I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys next week. Take care.